purpose of this how-to video is to demonstrate the ease of installation of the GMXP0 onto a steel surface using proprietary glue. The GMXP0 mounting plate has recently been changed with the addition of the graphical symbol which depicts the detector cable access point. The plate is a double-sided plate. One side of the plate is used for direct application onto a steel surface, which can either be drilled, welded, or glued. The other side of the plate, which is depicted with a drill symbol, is used for direct application onto concrete. For the purposes of the glue application, we will be using the weld side of the symbol, so this side of the plate will be visible when the plate is installed. There are two critical holes which we need to protect for the mounting of the detector, which are these two screws here, which line up with these two holes here. The GMXS1 internal test transmitter is secured in this location here, and it's very important that this hole is also protected from the ingress of glue. So when the glue is applied to the rear of the plate, which is now the concrete side of the plate, these holes are protected with small stickers. Prior to the installation of the plate onto the steel surface, ensure that the surface is clean from any foreign bodies, and if the surface is too smooth, use an abrasive material to ensure that we have a good bond between the steel surface and the mounting plate. Apply the glue evenly to the rear of the plate, but try and avoid any edges or holes which aren't being used, as surplus glue may protrude through these once the plate is installed. It is also important that the cable access point is in the correct orientation for the installation, as once the plate has been set, it cannot be changed. As the glue will normally take approximately 5 minutes to cure, it would be advantageous if the plate is mechanically held in position, or as we've done here, we've used four magnets which will hold the plate for the 5 minutes while the glue cures. Once the glue is set, the effectiveness of the bond between the two surfaces can be verified by striking the plate with a hammer. As detailed in the installation sheet for the detector, the two securing screws should be tightened to a force of 2 newtons. For this, you will require a Torx screwdriver, the GMXS1 internal test transmitter can now be secured into its final location and plugged into the appropriate connector. And now the installation is complete.